रुद्राय नमः, कालाय नमः, कलविकरणाय नमो, बलविकरणाय नमो, बलाय नमो, बलप्रमथनाय नमः, सर्वभूतदमनाय नमो, मनोन्मनाय नमः। अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो घोरघोरकरेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु। रुद्ररूपेभ्यः तत्पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्रः प्रचोदयात्। ईशान सर्वविद्यानां ईश्वर सर्वभूतानां ब्रह्माधिपतिर्ब्रह्मणोऽधिपतिर्ब्रह्मा शिवो मे अस्तु सदा शिवो। टुडे इट इज अमावास्या ऑफ निज आषाढ़ मास। टुडे आषाढ़ मास विल बी कंक्लूडेड। This year we got two Ashadha months, Adhika Ashadha, another one is Nija Ashadha. I don't want to go to the details related to this Nija Adhika because it is very much scientifically structured, mathematically calculated system. We need a separate class for the real understanding of these astro realities, astro insights. Today let us discuss about the religious significance attached to this Amavasya. This is called Bhima Amavasya. Here Bhima is the name given to Parashiva, Ishana. Bhagavan Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Rudranam Shankarascasmi. That is how Krishna projects himself as Shankara. Among all Ekadasha Rudra, 11 Rudras, I am Shankara. That is what Krishna says in the 10th chapter, which is called Vibhuti Yoga. Vibhuti, you know, various multiple manifestations. Multiple manifestation of divinity, Paramatma, it is called Vibhuti. The 10th chapter is called Vibhuti Yoga. Krishna says there, I am this, I am this, I am that. Rudranam Shankarascasmi Vitteshu Yaksharakshasam. That is how the shloka goes. So, according to Sri Krishna, as message, and according to the real projection of Vyasa Maharshi, we must remember that the Shankara form of Shiva, because Sham Karoti iti Shankara. Sham means solace, goodwill, welfare. So that Rudra Swarupa, that form of Lord Shiva, which spreads calmness, tranquility in the society, harmony in the society, that particular deity, Swarupa, Shiva Swarupa, that is called Shankara. So Krishna says, I am Shankara. That means Ashwatthaha sarvavrikshanam, I am Ashwatthaha tree among all other trees. Ruthunam kusumankaraha, I am the spring season among all seasons, six seasons. That is how he goes on giving this type of a list in the 10th chapter, Vibhuti Yoga. There he says, I am Shankara. Well, Krishna himself says that I am Shankara. You cannot make Shankara is some Shaiva or some Krishna is some Vaishnava. And this is Shaiva cult and this is Vaishnava cult, cult, cult. You cannot go for all these type of frictions and fractions. We cannot go. We must go for harmony. Eka eva deva. Eko deva sarvabhuteshu kodha. Sarvavyapi sarvabhutantaratma. Karmadhyaksha sarvabhutadhivasaha. Sakshi, Cheta, Kevalu, Nirgunascha. That is how Shveta, Shveta, Shvatara Upanishad says. So, Eko Deva. God is one. He got multiple, multiple manifestations. That's okay. As there are innumerable articles and particles in this material manifestation of Paramatma, you can give that much number to gods, so that it is 33 lakh crores, that is how 33 multiply. That means it is infinite. This is to be understood. So, according to our mythological description here today, Shiva Parvati must be worshipped. Because Shiva and Parvati, they represent that wonderful tradition of Garhasthya. How husband and wife must be totally integrated and they must be in Ardhanarishvara Swarupa. In that much of harmony and paraspara bhava, mutual understanding, they live together. They share both sorrow and happiness and they make penance for each other's welfare. That is what the paraspara tapasampat phalayita paraspara prapancha mata pitaro prancho jayapati stumaha. That is how a great poet projects these two, Shiva and Parvati. Parvati does tapas for Shiva and Shiva makes tapas for Parvati. Paraspara tapasampat phalayita paraspara. That is how they make penance for each other's welfare. That is the real ideal of couplehood in this tradition of household culture. That is the real culture here in this Bharata Bhumi. It is not something agreement, temporary agreement, something social, something. No. It is integration. It is Advaita Bhava. That is what the great poets say. Advaitam sukha dukha yoho. That is what Bhavabhuti says. Sukha and dukha, in both they must be Advaita Bhava. That is not how. How they must go for sharing and caring. That is the real Advaita. Vyavahara Advaita. Advaita in this living condition, in the real life. That is what tradition has been laid by our great rishis, Vasishtha Arundhati. Atri Anasuya. Kashyapa Aditi, all these great ideal couples of our tradition, they must be remembered, Shiva Parvati must be remembered. And today, newly married wives, they must take oaths to work for the welfare of their family, mainly husband. All these significance have been attached to this day. So, Amavasya actually this somehow in our traditional system is considered to be an inauspicious, not so much auspicious. अमावस्या का दिन जो है वो ऐसा शुभ दिन नहीं माना गया है, अशुभ दिन माना जाता है, किंतु कृष्ण पक्ष की इस अमावस्या के बारे में विशेष महत्ता, विशेष गुणवत्ता, विशेष सांप्रदायिक पारंपरिक महत्व योजित है, जुड़ा गया है। इस संदर्भ में हमको ये समझना चाहिए कि इस परंपरा में दाम्पत्य जीवन को एक अत्यंत श्रेष्ठ स्थान है, वो प्राण स्थान है। मनु महर्षि कहता है हमारे सामाजिक व्यवस्था में गृहस्थ आश्रम जो है वो प्राण स्थानीय है। कारण क्या है? ये गृहस्थ जो है दोनों मिलकर पति पत्नी न केवल अपने ग्रह के अपने जो गृहस्थी का धर्म है उसको ही निभाते, घर के अंदर ऐसा नहीं, घर के बाहर भी वो ब्रह्मचारियों का पोषण करते हैं, सन्यासियों का भी पोषण करते हैं, वृद्धों का सेवा की सेवा करते हैं। इस तरह पूरी समाज की व्यवस्था के प्राण स्वरूप होते हैं हमारे गृहस्थ। इसलिए गृहस्थाश्रम एक पवित्र परंपरा के रूप में इस समाज में था, अभी है, रहेगा, रहना चाहिए, नहीं तो पूरा समाज बिगड़ जाएगा, नरक में पतित हो जाएगा। आज की गंभीर स्थिति ऐसी है, हम देख रहे हैं। इसी तरह हमारे एक गृहस्थ धर्म का, पारिवारिक संस्कृति का पतन हो जाए तो पूरा समाज भ्रष्ट हो जाएगा। इसलिए आज के इस संदर्भ में हमारे जो महिलाएं खास करके जो गृहस्थी निभाते हैं उनको अपने पति के पूरे उदात्त जीवन की कामना करने का एक अच्छा मौका, अवसर आज का है। इस दिन के लिए यह अमावस्या बहुत प्रचलित है, यह समझना चाहिए। अब इस संदर्भ में हमको यह भी समझना है कि हमारे इस भारत भूमि में क्या कोई स्पर्धा है? क्या पति के खिलाफ स्पर्धा करने वाले पत्नी, पत्नी के खिलाफ कोई कटुता, शाठ्य, इस तरह का व्यवहार करने वाला कोई पति? ये नहीं है। ये हमारे इस स्मृति में, इस श्रुति पक्ष में, इस समाज के सामाजिक व्यवस्था में स्वीकृत सत्य नहीं है। ऐसे कुछ लोग होंगे, कुछ ऐसे पत्नियां होंगे, कुछ पति भी होंगे, देयर मे बी सम हस्बैंड्स एंड वाइव्स ऑफ दिस टाइप ऑफ कैकोफोनिक एटीट्यूड्स, बट दे आर नॉट अप्रूव्ड बाय दिस सोसाइटी, दे हैव नो सैंक्शन फ्रॉम अवर ट्रेडिशन फॉर देयर मिसबिहेवियर्स। हियर इट इज द टोटल हार्मोनी बिटवीन वाइव्स एंड। आजकल क्या हो रहा है? ये स्पर्धाएं चल रही है, ये पुरुष लोग दौड़ते हैं, कबड्डी खेलते हैं, हम भी खेलेंगे, ये हम भी खेलेंगे, ये क्या बात है? ऐसा नहीं है ना, ये प्रकृति की व्यवस्था है, स्त्री स्त्री है, पुरुष पुरुष है, स्पर्धा नहीं करना चाहिए। पुरुष भी अपनी प्रकृति के अनुसार व्यवहार करें, स्त्री भी अपनी प्रकृति के अनुसार व्यवहार करें, भगवान कृष्ण कहता है। तो स्त्री की क्या है महत्ता, शक्ति क्या है? वास्तव में स्त्री शक्ति का ही स्वरूप है, उसमें क्या शक्ति है? भगवान कृष्ण कहता है उसी में दशमाध्याय में, कहता है इन द सेम चैप्टर ही हाइलाइट्स दैट क्वालिटी विच वॉज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय स्त्री शक्ति। कीर्ति ही श्री ही वाक्च नारीणाम स्मृति ही मेधा धृति ही क्षमा। So he gives this list of qualities which are normally present in mahilas, naris. What is that? Kirti, Because they got that wonderful capacity, brain capacity, emotional capacity. Actually, emotional intelligence, that is the real quality of all women. That much emotional intelligence, by nature, men cannot have. God has given this emotional intelligence, which is highly quoted now in the psychology. That is the real strength of every woman. Emotional intelligence. Sometimes intelligent, that part may be more among them. But as far as emotional intelligence that is concerned, that is the real power center of Mahila Shakti. That is to be strengthened. That is why Krishna says, Kirtihi. By their virtue, by their emotional intelligence, they become popular. Shrihi, and they can earn sampad. That capacity also they have. Vak, that is their real strength, because their that very melodious voice makes many things convinced. In our tradition, there are some samhitas. Prabhu Samhita, Mitra Samhita, Kanta Samhita, these words are there. Kanta Samhita means that type of convincing art which normally wives adopt to convince their husbands. That particular art, communication art, that is the real property of Nari Shakti. They have that one. That is why many people after getting married, they become good people. Many मर्द हमारे मर्द लोग जो होते हैं जो व्यसन के अधीन होते हैं अत्यंत बुरी व्यवहार व्यवहार में बिगड़ गए भटके हुए ऐसे भी नौजवान विवाह के पश्चात अच्छे होते हैं। यदि कांता समित यानी वो पत्नी अपने स्वभाव उदात्त चरित्र से प्रभाव डालती है इसके परिणाम स्वरूप वो पति अच्छा होता है। ये उदाहरण मिलते हैं इस तरह कीर्ति श्री ही वाक्य नारी नाम स्मृति दट रिमेंबरेंस मेधा होल्डिंग कैपेसिटी ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कैपेसिटी मेधा इज नॉट ओनली इंटेलेक्चुअल इट इज इवन ऑर्गेनाइजिंग मेधा स्मृति ही मेधा धृति होल्डिंग इफ समथिंग इम्बैलेंस टेक्स प्लेस इनसाइड द हाउस सम कैकोफोनी स्टार्ट्स सम डिस्पैरिटी सम एनामली सम प्रॉब्लम frictions, immediately she got that capacity to normalize, neutralize, so that she brings that harmony, samarasata, samarasya, that capacity she got. Smriti ji medha adhiti, and the ultimate one, kshama, forgive, forget and forgive, highest quality. Without this, we cannot live harmoniously. That's why these are the qualities enlisted, these are present among all Mahilas, Naris. With this Shakti, they can strengthen whole family. So now today, all wives, they pray to God for the welfare of their family and their husband. That in that context, they go for some religious practices and so many things. So that much significance it is attached to this particular day. From tomorrow it is Shravana Masa. The Shravana Masa, all 30 days is full of festivals. Shravana and Bhadrapada, these 2 months we have many festivals. Followers of different cult, different sect, they all have their festivity. They celebrate it. So let us carry this message knowing fully well the significance attached to this particular day.